Being able to manage the permissions of your users as they interact with your Tabular cube is really important. And in this video, we're going to take a look at using roles to help facilitate that process. Now, in a previous video, when we were talking about processing a cube, we had jumped into SQL Server Management Studio and created a role directly through here. It was as simple as right click, new role, and we went through that. The problem with that is as soon as we make any update to our model here in Visual Studio and deploy it, it's just going to override that. And in this case, it actually deleted it. So what we need to do is be able to create them within our project. And that's what we'll look at here. So roles are ways to group users and limit their permissions based on operations, maybe reading, processing, as well as row level security or specific columns or tables that you want visibility to. Now within here, there are two different ways you can get to that. Obviously we have roles over here. You could right click and go to roles and it'll bring up the role manager. The other option is go to model roles. It'll get you to the same place and this screen will look very similar to what we saw in Management Studio. So what we'll do here is we'll add a new role, we'll add a user to it and then view the results in Excel by logging in as different users. So we'll start off here, we'll create a new role. I'll just call this test role. Permissions, here you can see, are we giving it permissions to read, read and process, just process? Do we want them to be an admin? So this is nice as you build it out for your organization. You can group individuals or services or whatever into different roles and be able to consolidate where you're setting those permissions. In this case, we'll just do read. We're going to create a read only role. You could put a description, I won't in this case. And now down here, we can see it's recognizing the tables that we have and you can implement row level security. If you're curious about row level security, there's a separate video that covers this. We won't add anything here in this case. Members, this is where you can specify your users or groups for this role. So maybe you have an Active Directory group of users. You could do that here. Or like it says, individual users. In our case, I'm going to add another user on my machine that's called admin and add this here. So this will be the only member that is going to inherit the permissions of this role. The next tab here is tables and columns. And this is actually something different compared to what you would see here in Management Studio when if you try to create, let's say, a read only role, you don't have the ability to restrict visibility to specific tables and columns outside of row level security. In this case, we can actually easily go through and select them. And what I'll point out here is this is indicating what should not be visible to users. So by default, everything is turned on, but if you want something not to be visible, you would select it here. So let's say for this case, we do not want internet sales visible. So it's going to select every single column and we'll select OK. Now we can see this role over here and who's in it. We can see admin is within this test role. We'll save and let's go ahead and deploy this. So again, now that we're deploying, it's going to include this role that we created and it would override anything that was there with whatever's set in this project file. Close. Let's hop back into Visual Studio and refresh. And we can see here now this role exists and it was deployed with read access here in our server on Management Studio. So now let's actually see what this looks like as a result. So now let's take a look at the result from a user perspective. I'm going to open up a brand new Excel sheet and go to data, get data, and we'll connect to our analysis services server here. This is the user that will not have any restrictions. We won't select this one. We'll select the Tabular demo, which is the deployed demo. This one is what's in our working environment. And we'll do the full cube finish. So we can see here, we have every model here, including specifically internet sales. But what I'll do now is open up a new sheet and connect again. But this time I'll connect as the user, that admin user that had the restricted permissions. Same cube, finish, okay. Let's minimize these. And we can see here, we don't have that internet sales view here. If we go back to the other one, here it is. We go to admin and it's gone. Let's go back now and make another change just to see how this flows through. Let's go back to this role. And this time what we'll do is allow visibility to just a few of these columns here, just to show you how this works. Like I mentioned before, anything that's selected here is not going to be visible. We are going to give visibility to these, but any of these other ones that are still checked will not have visibility for anybody in this role. Okay. Now we'll save and deploy again. We're back in Excel. I have not refreshed it, but what we'll do here is right click and refresh. And now over here, we can see internet sales. We have those few columns, but we don't have the ones that we excluded. If we go to the original one, refresh, we go to my MJK user. This one has all of them, admin, just a few. That's an introduction to using roles within your tabular model. It's another way to manage your users and permissions, some visibility as well, and can be used in conjunction with some of the other tools such as role level security, perspectives, and things like that.